Do you have all over the place syndrome? Are you always in firefighter mode? The other day I was speaking with my coach and telling him how overwhelmed I was feeling. Yes, it happens to coaches too. And after I finished describing my challenges, he said, you sound like you have all over the place syndrome. Well, as soon as he said it, I knew he was right. Luckily, I knew what to do next. It's what I do with my clients. I help my creative genius clients who struggle with all over the place syndrome to get intentional about what they are committed to. And together we create a clear path to help them unleash their creative genius. Creative geniuses often get hit with all over the place syndrome because they have so many brilliant ideas and can't decide which one to do first. They jump from one task to another, diluting their efforts between too many projects. So in this video, I'll share a few steps to help you if you find yourself with all over the place syndrome. First, start first by taking 3 deep breaths. Now, how does this help? It changes the chemistry in your brain and allows you to tap into your thinking brain rather than your reptilian fight, flight, or freeze brain. Secondly, when you've calmed down, do a brain dump. Write down everything you have bouncing around in your head, then let it go for a moment. You don't have to worry you'll forget anything because, well, you've just captured your ideas on paper. They are safe. Third, get clear on your top 3 projects for the next 3 months. Write them in a mind map if that helps you, or prepare a project task list for each project. Then start writing the tasks related to each of the projects on its own mind map or appropriate task list. Fifth, you want to separate your emotional worry from the things you need to do. Ask, is there a reason to worry about this now? Now, if the answer is yes, ask, is there some action that I can take to correct or alleviate the worry? In other words, is this something I can control? If the answer to that question is yes, write the steps you can take in your mind map or project task list, and then plan the actions for the appropriate time of the day to do them. Now, if it's not something that you can control, ask, is this life-threatening? If not, let it go. If it is life-threatening, ask for help from someone who has control. Now, if it's not something you should worry about right now, write it in the project task list for future consideration or schedule it for later next week. Sixth, you want to select the top 2 or 3 tasks for each project and schedule them in your agenda for the best time to accomplish them.